Hey guys, welcome back to Light the Fire Outdoors. We're in the process right now of this hunting season. It just started on Sunday of kind of getting our ducks lined up in a row, so to speak. We got to get our residency so we can hunt here cheaper than being a non-resident. And right now we're going to go get our body and mind right at the gym and do a little bench press and my favorite. Then we're going to go get the bow tuned up because the rest is a little off from the moving and all that. Got a couple strings loose and stuff, so my rest isn't quite working right, so got to get all that stuff ready to go before we can go slay some deer and get on the board. But I'm loving what you guys are doing. You're sending in all kinds of pictures of deer. I've seen huge bucks, I've seen lots of ducks, and I think it's fantastic you guys are getting out there and doing it. So keep doing what you're doing. God bless, and I'll pray for you, and I hope you fill all your bags with lots of animals. But until we get to go out, I'm gonna go lift so I can just get stronger and chase those animals farther, because I think we might be able to hunt some bear this year. And if I have to wrestle one, I want to be ready. Got our swole on. Now it's time to go fix my issue with the bow. I'm going to show you guys kind of what we have going on here. Alright, so I was out shooting it the other day, put it in at 20 yards. Should have been an easy kick shot, and I was shooting way low and I couldn't figure out what was going on. I mean, obviously my pins aren't in the best shape, but they're still on. They're just kind of halfway broken, so the fiber part is. But anyway, what I figured out was going on is my rest was only going up about, I don't know, about halfway, about like that. So it was letting the arrow was shooting way low, and I couldn't figure out what was going on, why it was causing it. Well, turns out this knot right here is tied a little loose, and that's the issue we're going to go evaluate. I'm going to head down to a local archery shop here, and we're going to take a look at this and see what we're going to do about it. All right. We got the bow all fixed up and tuned up. What was going on is that the cable was slipping a little bit, so the guy tied a little bit bigger knot. So anyway, we're back home now, and we're going to head outside here in a little bit to go take the bow out to practice. And I mentioned that to Jess, and she's like, oh, I want to go outside and shoot too. But what she doesn't know, it's going to be a competition, and I'm going to win. So let's get out there and kick some butt.
Hi, my name's Jess, and I'm happy to say that my first appearance on Light the Fires Outdoors is going to include Aaron's butt whipping.
All right, it's time for the butt kicking. So we're gonna We're gonna put some stakes on this one.
Stakes? What kind of stakes?
Well, deer stakes eventually.
Oh, but, venison.
So if I win, we go check out that public hunting spot I wanted to do today. What do you get if you win?
If I win, Aaron and I both get a pedicure, but it's on Aaron's dime.
I'm gonna win.
Your redneck friend, I'm about to show them how country folks does it again. Ain't nothing changed since you seen me last. Still living kind of slow and talking kind of fast. Chasing them turkeys, eating beef jerky, hanging out down at the lake. Looking at Emmett Lou with a two-piece on, and ain't nothing on that girl face.
The line judges here, they've surveyed the field. A tail wag, so it's good to go, right, Penny? Right, Penny? Okay, it's good to go. All right, our first shot is 22 yards, aiming at the vital spot of the deer target.
We don't need much here for fishing poles and guns and trucks with four-wheel drives. Cause I'm in everything, and here hang saying, your country folks can't survive. We need to get on back into the simple life of what made this country great. And that was helping each other, loving our brother. Lord, I just can't wait. Cause we like to hunt, fish, play out in the mud. That's the way we do around here. So now you know what's up. If you don't like what we do, then go back to where you from.
Shit. Practice shot. I don't even take a practice shot. I'll get her in the method.
Oh.
She hit the deer's leg, so they could have killed it, but I'm kind of killed it.
Zebco reeling and shotgun shooting. Catfish frying in the little boot scooting. Coming everybody, let's all get down. Show the city folks our country sound. It's a boot nanny, so bring your granny, cause we have fun around here.
As you can see, all the arrows are carefully placed in the heart and lung region of said deer here. And I don't know, it's a little bit bigger than a 50 cent piece, not bad for being a little rusty since last season. So let's see how the lady does. She's aiming for a top spot here.
Might make you have a heart attack. Said we love skinny dip and going cow tipping and hunting a big old hog. Dogs start running, Lord, that's fun. And better watch out for that log. Now let's get on back to the tents and trucks and light that bonfire up.
So all right, this is my round one. As you can see, my circle isn't as tight as Mr. Stonehawker's is. However, I would have killed the deer all four times. That's very important. Is venison in the freezer.
You would have killed it all four times? We're gonna let Miss Nesser here decide where we shoot from round two. Maybe she'll pick a spot that she can shoot a little bit better from.
Alright, round two, right here.
Now y'all know that's how we roll, so please fill up my cup. Cause we like to hunt, fish, play out in the mud. That's the way we do round here.
Okay, enough loving on the dogs. Let's go see the results of round two.
Okay.
So as you can see here, my skills have dramatically improved as I'm definitely within a quarter now this time. This is an extremely dead deer. We gave him four shots for good measure. We did one twisting completely 180 degrees. It's a shot that should only be attempted by an expert, so I wouldn't expect Jess to do it on this next round, but we'll see how she does.
Y'all, it's your redneck friend. I'm about to show them how country folks does it again. Ain't nothing changed since you seen me last. Still living kind of slow.
What do you think about this round? Whoa, taking him out before we can see the results? I mean, vast improvement. 3 out of 4 hits this time. She got one spine, so that's a dead deer.
Yeah, I had one spine.
And one lung.
One lung. Yep, and here and
here. Heck yeah, she got 2 dead deer on that one. All right.
Talking kind of fast, chasing them turkeys, eating beef jerky, hanging out down at the lake. Looking at Emmett Lou with a 2-piece on, and ain't nothing on that girl fake. We don't need much here but fishing poles and guns and trucks with 4-wheel drives. Cause it meant everything to hear Hank sing. Can't survive. We need to get on back into the simple life of what made this country great. And that was helping each other, loving our brother. Lord, I just can't wait. Cause we like to hunt, fish, play out in the mud. That's the way we do around here. So now you know what's up. If you don't like what we do, then go back to where you from. We like to hunt, fish, play out in the mud. We all mud digging, love frog gigging, catch fireflies in the mayonnaise. Creekside kissing and largemouth fishing. We just can't help it, that's who we are. Zebco reeling and shotgun shooting. Catfish frying in the little boot scooting. Come on everybody, let's all get down. Show the city folks our country sound. It's a hootin' and it's a bring your granny. Cause we have fun round here. And you can do anything that you want to. But honey, just don't spill my beer. So just pass the sign and we'll all be fine. My granddaddy made that jug. And it's 200 proof, it'll blow off the roof. Cause that's just like grandpa does. Cause we like to hunt, fish, play out in the mud. That's the way we do round here. So now you know what's up. If you don't like what we do, then go back to where you from. We like.
So as you can see here, most of the rounds I had here was kind of tailored towards the heart and lungs here. Because the deer is quartering away on the shot we had, I'm actually aiming a little bit further back because the arrow's coming in at an angle. This is a real deer. It'd be going in and up through the front of him, catching both lungs and possibly heart as well. I'm just doing it to win this competition, so I don't have to get a pedicure. So I don't know if you can see this or not, but all three of these arrows are like touching each other. And this guy, let's not worry about this guy.
And a coon dog tree in a 3 a.m. It might make you have a heart attack. Said we love skinny dip and go and captive in and hunting a big old hog. Dogs start running, Lord, that's fun. I better watch out for that log. Now let's get on back to the tents and trucks and light that bonfire up.
Boat him. He would have killed 2 of them. He smoked him.
Yeah.
That a girl. Heart shot, lung shot.
My girl busy.
2 neck shots. Dude, you juked him. Stuck him right in the jugular! Sweet! Well, while Jessica is going and getting her diaper cleaned, I figured I'd talk a little bit about what we just did outside. We had a competition. I won, naturally. But pretty much, getting out there and practicing no matter how you do it, competitively, incompetitively, it always hones your skills on what you're going to need to do when the actual deer season rolls around. For me, as you guys know, I had a little issue with my bow, so it was even more important that I got out there when my bow was fixed to make sure everything was still working right and working the way I know it should. That way when I go outside and I'm actually sitting there in the tree stand and it's a moment of truth, the deer is there, I know my gear is going to work right, I know everything's tuned right, everything's going the way it should. And then for people like Jessica, she's been out twice so far. She hasn't had any luck really, a couple close encounters, but she hasn't got a shoot at a deer. So for her, it's even more important. And everybody else that's newer to the sport to actually get out and get as much practice in as possible. Because as you can see, each one of those rounds, we only shot 3 rounds out there, so 12 arrows, she improved each time. And that's the biggest part, just getting out there, get consistent, get comfortable with your form and everything, and just get better at it. So I'm going to go check on her because she's been crying an awful lot, so maybe she needs some water. She might be dehydrated, and I'm not getting a manicure today. So we enjoyed having you, and I look forward to next time.